When I came in as governor in 2009 at Utah, we were at the height of the recession. And like most governors, what do? To turn the economy around. We had an unemployment rate of 8.4%. And the first thing I did with our senior staff and our cabinet members was, you know, we need to set some goals and say, this is what we're going to do to turn this economy around. And all of my staff members carry a card here still today that talks about this lofty goal that we had here in Utah of becoming the best performing economy in America and a premier global business destination. Which, you know, for a state that's about 2.85 million people, you know, that's nestled in the Rocky Mountains, that's a pretty audacious goal. But we understood that we could do that if we, in fact, created an environment that was conducive for the small business entrepreneur and create business and empower the private sector. We also recognized that you couldn't do it, certainly not long term, if you did not have an educated and skilled labor force. And so I brought together business people, I brought together the educators and the stakeholders involved in education and said, what do we need to do? And unanimously, they said, we've got to raise the level of education in Utah. And so we created what we call the goal of 66 by 2020, meaning that two-thirds of our adult population would have some post-high school education in some form or another. So trade schools, certifications, two-year associate degrees, but something post-high school. We go around to the high schools, junior highs, and elementary schools, and we use the phrase from the governor that says, if you want a good job, get a good education. We are emphasizing, we're making it a culture that you aspire to more education, certainly past high school. And all education is good. We've also added to that, though, that there needs to be an alignment factor. You kind of made the joke earlier, Joel did, about somebody getting a degree, but then they're going to go out and dig ditches. You know, the one we've used is that what is the most common phrase of somebody has a PhD in philosophy? Well, you have fries with that hamburger. You need to find a job skill set that aligns up with the demands of the marketplace. And so in the last 3 years, we've put a significant amount of money into what we call the STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and math. It goes along with our two-year associate degrees, with our trade schools, our Utah technical colleges that we have in abundance out there, to say you need to get skills that line up. We're spending money now on better counseling. Now, parents should do it. Parents ought to be the ones to counsel their students or their children. But sometimes they don't know what's available in the marketplace. And the marketplace changes and is flexible out there. But counselors in our schools have the ability to work with our students to find out what are your aptitudes, what do you have desires to do, what will fit with your own personality. And here are the jobs available, and here's the skills that are required. So we get them on a path of alignment. We're putting a lot more money into the engineering aspects. We know that we have been graduating 20% of what the available jobs are in the marketplace when it comes to engineering, technology, and math. And so our emphasis there of this alignment is important. And by the way, that aspect of our economy is growing at twice what the rest of the economy is growing as far as creating of jobs, and it pays about 26% more money. Which means that these people will put more money into taxes, which will help us fund the expanded need and growth pressures for higher education. So it really is a win-win for everybody. And frankly, I believe that as we do this, our ability to have the rising tide of a growing, expanding economy lifts all boats on the pond. And no matter what your pet issue is, if the economy is healthy, then again, other things are benefited.